It's one of the most difficult jobs in sports, deciding whether a baseball pitch is a ball or a strike, hundreds of times a game. Did the ball, often moving at nearly 100 miles an hour, travel over the 17-inch wide plate? And did it stay between the batter's shoulders and his knees? It's a task that tests the limits of the human eye and the human brain. And not surprisingly, umps sometimes make mistakes to the frustration of hitters, pitchers, managers, and fans. Now, two University of Maryland researchers and a local inventor have developed an automated system they say will all but eliminate these mistakes. The idea was hatched with Hagerstown's Jerry Spessard. He's been around baseball more than 40 years. As a kid, he played on two Little League World Series teams, and he later coached his own son, who became a star in College Park.
I played a lot of baseball myself. My son played here at the University of Maryland, and so I've attended many, many baseball games. And the two factors that offend me are the umpire doing incorrect calls and taking a game away from the batter or the pitcher. And number two, when I go to a baseball game, I go to enjoy it. And I hate the verbal abuse that the umpire has to take.
Spessard isn't a scientist, and he needed help to make his home plate idea a reality. So he came to the Maryland Technology Enterprise Institute, or MTEC, which connects entrepreneurs to university researchers who bring ideas from concept to market. There, Spessard met Maryland computer engineering professor Chris Davis. He had no interest in baseball, but was still intrigued.
I thought it was a really neat opportunity to use optics to solve yet another interesting problem. And my lack of interest in baseball didn't deter me from being interested in this as a scientific problem to be solved.
After several months of work, Davis and his research associate, John Raza, came up with a model.
The key features of this prototype are two slots front and back from which a vertical curtain of infrared light comes up and two photodetectors. And the photodetectors will pick up the light that illuminates the baseball and scatters it down. And that tells you a baseball has crossed the plate.
Software translates the sensor's data into balls or strikes. It also collects data on the speed, location, and angle of pitches.
I feel that the electronic home plate is going to be a training device in the first couple of years, where it's going to be used in the bullpen, it's going to be used for practice games and inter-squad games, and they're going to get so used to it that eventually will end up in games.
Spessard isn't the first to invent an automated model that determines balls and strikes. Every major league ballpark has a sophisticated multi-camera system, but the TV networks use it more to give fans a better view of the action and less to come to the aid of the umps. Each of those systems costs millions. The electronic home plate, though, will be much more affordable.
What we're trying to do is give a system where you can get that same type of information basically anywhere there's a baseball field.
Even though he grew up playing cricket across the pond, Chris Davis has become more interested in baseball since starting the project.
I'm exactly the same name as Crush Davis from the Baltimore Orioles, who's having a fantastic season. So there is an instant connection in a way.
Davis and Raza are now in the process of ironing out kinks in the device, and they hope to have a finished version early next year. Then Spessard will begin manufacturing, and he plans to take the electronic home plate to market by next summer.